The following is a commercial program paid for by Little Rock Trojan Sports Properties, Learfield, and the University of Arkansas, Little Rock. The opinions and views expressed belong to its sponsors and are not those of Mission Broadcasting Incorporated, Nexstar Broadcasting Incorporated, this station, or their affiliates or employees. There is a new head Trojan in Little Rock to lead Little Rock's team. He's no stranger to Arkansas and the game of basketball. He has coached in the NBA and now brings his coaching ability to Little Rock to lead the Trojans. This is the Darrell Walker Coaches Show with host Ray Tucker. The Darrell Walker Coaches Show is brought to you by Stevens Incorporated, Cleve Addy Incorporated, Zips Car Wash, Glazers Distributing, and these fine brands. We urge you to drink responsibly. And Dillard's Department Stores. Here with Ray Tucker is head Trojan, Darrell Walker.
There's an old saying, what a difference a day makes. Well, in college basketball and the Sun Belt Conference, what a difference a week makes. If you're a Little Rock Trojan men's basketball fan, it was a terrific week as Darrell's teams went 2-0. And, Coach, you were preaching and talking about to your guys when we got back home. First time we played a home game in over a month, and you preached to your guys, hey, just come back home, win two, and we're right back in the thick of things.
Yeah, you know, I have a young team, and I felt they were a little down after the loss to Louisiana Lafayette. And I just told the guys in the locker room, if you go home, you win two games, you'd be 2-2, and you may be in fifth place. Never thought we'd be in third place.
All right, let's take a look at the league standings, if you don't mind, and we'll see exactly what Darrell was talking about. Georgia State is at top of the pack.
As usual.
That's another story we'll talk about a little bit later, something that happened in the game there. But you look at it, there are eight teams at 2-2. I don't know in all my years in the Sun Belt that I've ever seen that.
I think it's a lot of balance in the conference. We haven't played everybody, and I haven't seen everybody. And, of course, we're getting ready for Texas State. But overall, if you look at the conference, there's a lot of balance in the conference.
Georgia State's 4-0, Texas State's 3-1. Next up's Texas State. We'll talk about that in the final segment. Louisiana's 2-2, Georgia Southern, Troy, ULM, South Alabama, Arkansas State, and Little Rock. And Texas Arlington's in there, so you got Texas Arlington also. All right, first game we played Troy at the Jack Stevens Center, and a very, very nice win and a nice crowd on hand.
No, we had a good crowd, and I was just excited about how we played defensively. These guys came out, they followed the game plan. We were able to hold a really good Troy basketball team to 59 points, which I thought was outstanding, and was very proud of the guys, the way they competed on the defensive side of the ball.
You know, coming in, I remember saying on the radio broadcast, well, Troy's not a very good three-point shooting team. They went 1 of 11 the first half, 3 of 9 the second half, 4 of 20, they shot 20%, and kind of doomed them.
Well, a lot of those shots were contested. In the beginning of the year, we were giving up a lot of three-point shots that wasn't contested, right? But now we're out there contesting shots.
We're looking at some of the highlights here, and that Troy's in the dark uniforms, Little Rock in the home uniforms. Going down low, here comes Chris Bankson, who's a dunk machine, Coach.
Oh, you know, he's in the top, 10 or 12 in field goal percentage in the country. I got to find a way to get him some more shots. He really finishes around the rim.
You guys in the first half were 9 of 32, 28%. Second half, much better.
Yes.
16 to 30, 53%. For the game, you end up shooting 40%.
Well, you know what? That stat you just said, Ray, 40%, that's great. And I told my guys, look, you're not going to shoot a good percentage every night, but if you defend, you're still going to have a chance to win basketball games, especially if you don't turn the basketball over. And we only turned the ball over 13 times, Ray, so that helped us a lot.
You turned it over, three times, four times in the second
half? Yeah, that means we got more shot attempts at the basket. Yeah, that's a little Marquise Noel right there passing off to Lottie for a shot. Marquise is doing a better job of running my basketball team. He really is. He's starting to grow up a little bit.
You got four players in double figures in this game. Marquise had 16. Rajon had 14. DeAndre Burns coming off the bench added 12. And Kamani Johnson had 11. That's a young man I want to talk about who has a nose for the basketball.
Well, you know, I inserted Kamani into the lineup, Ray, because he plays with a lot of energy. He brings us some toughness, even though he's a freshman, and he goes after the ball. He has a knack for getting his hands on the ball.
Troy came in feeling pretty good about themselves. The two Alabama teams did. They didn't fare well in the state of Arkansas.
Well, they should feel good. Those two bigs they got, Hicks and Bernardo, are pretty good. Probably the two best bigs in the conference.
That was Rajon Tucker scoring on a bucket there. Here's Marquise Noel. Kicks it out. Got a wide open shooter, which is your 6'10 player.
Nicola can shoot the ball. He also can post, but he also can shoot the basketball. So we have some offensive weapons. I'm just proud and happy about the way we've been defending, Ray. To me, that's the biggest thing, is the way we've been defending.
Do you think Nicola's ever heard the phrase bull in a china shop?
Hey, this guy gets more traveling calls and more offensive fouls, and part of that is because we talked about it last time on the show, Ray. He's played overseas. It's a more physical game. You're allowed to get away with more things. Now he's in the United States, and the game is totally officially a different way. And so he's having a tough time adjusting to that. So
watching your guys celebrate a little bit, Marquise knocks down a three there. When you get balanced scoring like that, you got Burns coming off the bench, Lottie coming off the bench, it's a totally different ball club.
Man, it's, when you can get points off the bench, you can talk to any coach. When you can get points off the bench, that's a weapon in itself. And you got Dre, and now I have Lottie coming off the bench. So I got some guys that can come off the bench and really help us. And, you know, not even talking about, you know, Ryan Pippins, who's been playing well the whole year for us, Ray.
I'm looking on my stat sheet here. Troy came in 8-7, 1-2 in the Sun Belt. And so you guys are right in the thick of things here as this one winds down, Coach.
Well, no, I'm excited about our team. I'm excited about going on the road to play Texas State and UT Arlington. If our defensive game travels, we'll be just fine on the road.
It was nice to be back at the Jack Stevens Center. It was nice to see a good crowd.
Didn't think I were ever going to get back to my house or to the Jack Stevens Center. And it was a really lovely crowd. And I want to thank the fans again that came out and support this young basketball team. It's good to see everybody in the stands.
Played South Alabama on Saturday. And we'll talk more about that when we come back with more of the Darrell Walker Coaches Show.
And shameful. There's never an acceptable reason for driving dirty. Not with Zips Unlimited Wash Club. For as little as $14.95 a month, members join Unlimited Washes. That's less than 50 cents a day. So, show some pride and Zips your ride. Join Zips Unlimited Wash Club today. Zips 3-Minute Car Wash. Zip in, zip out, zip on.
When did Too Big to Fail replace Too Smart to Fail? When did trend overtake truth? When did putting clients first stop being second nature? For us, never.
You can't take a risk in any investment that if it goes wrong and you lose it all, that you endanger the ability of the firm to survive. And that's really what Wall Street forgot.
So when do you want to learn more about Stevens, one of the country's most successful investment banking firms?
For something dependable this outdoor season? Then you're ready for Steel Outdoor Power Equipment. Cleve Addy Outdoor Equipment on Geyer Springs offers you a full line of steel products built for power and dependability. Trimmers, blowers, chainsaws, edgers, and lots more. Steel products provide comfort and features that help you get the job done right. Craig and the staff at Cleve Addy have a long list of satisfied customers because your needs are their top priority. Are you ready for more power? Get to Cleve Addy Outdoor Equipment on Geyer Springs today.
It's not just a coaster, you know. It's an invitation. Jim Beam on the rocks. The bourbon that's been making history since 1795 invites you to make some of your own.
We told you at the outset, the Trojans went 2-for-2 this past week at the Jack Stevens Center. Game two was against South Alabama. That was on Saturday. Trojans ended up winning that one 91-62. In your wildest dreams, did you think your basketball team would shoot that well?
No, I know we can shoot the basketball, but not 61% from the field and 46% from the three-point line, no. But once again, I know I don't want to sound redundant, but I know we got 91, but I'm happy that the team got 62 and the last team before that got 59. So I'm excited about the way we're playing defensively.
And defense is the name of the game, and you talk about it all the time. And we're going on the road later this week to make the Texas swing. And the thing you kept telling me yesterday was, hey, can we carry this defense with us? I sure hope you pack it somewhere.
No, we're going to pack it. We're going to pack it. I'm going to talk about it again in practice today. We have to get out there and defend on the road. You defend on the road and you rebound, you take care of the basketball, Ray, you're going to have a good chance to win a game.
And very few turnovers in these two games compared to what we've been having. Let's take a look at highlights from the game against South Alabama on Saturday at the Jack Stevens Center. You know what? Early on, about 15 minutes before, and the crowds these days are late arriving crowds, I'm looking around and I went, where is everybody? And the next thing I know, I think we had the biggest crowd of the year.
We had a good crowd and they were really energized and they were really into the game. And we gave them something to cheer about because we we put on a good performance offensively and defensively.
South Alabama's got a lot of guns in their arsenal, and so does Little Rock.
Yeah, they, both teams can score, but we really shut them down defensively. When we get stops, we're able to get the ball out and push the ball and get some easy baskets, and that's what we did.
We'll take a close look at these highlights and kind of ID some things. That's number three, Rayshon Tucker. We'll have a feature on him just a bit later in the show.
Rayshon's playing well, playing at a high level, and showing some leadership. Mr. Offense himself, DeAndre Burns. Everybody was shocked. All the players jumped up off the bench and said, DeAndre dunked the basketball.
I never seen that.
Nobody could believe that, so I was laughing, and I was happy for Dre because he's been out a long time with that turf toe.
You know, something really stood out to me was the involvement in the bench and the excitement coming from your bench.
Yeah, the bench, I had told my guys, bench guys, you have to be involved in the game whether you're in the game or not, and you saw it this last game against South Alabama.
All right, you've been hit by the injury bug. Dre Burns is one of those guys that we just saw score a basket, saw a dunk, had turf toe, right. Sidelined him for a good while, and it's real easy to sting that, and when he does, he has to go back and sit down. He looks pretty healthy now.
No, he was healthy this game. He was in the rhythm. All the guys on the bench was pulling for him, and he's instant offense off the bench. That's the one reason why I like bringing Dre off the bench, because I know he can go get me 10 or 20 off the bench real fast.
If you feed the ball in to Bankston, Chris Bankston down low like that, it's instant.
I don't know what Chris is shooting. I don't know if it's 70 or 80%. It's probably down to 65, 70%, but he's shooting at a high clip.
I think he's still in the upper 70s or 80%.
He doesn't miss many.
There's Kamani Johnson. A lot of emotion out of that young man.
Yeah, you like Kamani. He's playing well. He's rebounding the basketball. He's doing everything that I'm asking him to do. And it's still a learning process for him because he's a freshman, right?
Number 11 for you is Jacek Lottie, who is a sophomore out of Colorado. And a young man that brings a lot of energy and leadership to your basketball team. Broke a finger in the Memphis game. He's back and healthy.
His finger's still not healthy, but let me tell you something. Lottie just energizes the whole team on the offensive side and the defensive side of the ball, and I am so happy to have him back because he just plays with a different type of energy than everybody else on my team.
Number 55 is Nikola Maric, who is a 6'10", 250-pound true freshman out of Bosnia, and he is a banger and can step out and shoot the three.
No, he can shoot the ball. Don't misunderstand that, Ray. He can shoot the ball. He just doesn't go out there and shoot the ball a lot. If he's open, he will shoot it. He gives us a post presence that we haven't had. And there he is right there. He's a big load down there now. He is a big load.
You let him get the ball in the circle. He's unstoppable.
Now that's us. We're defending right there, and that's out in the passing lane, and we're sharing the basketball. Rewarding Kamani for a dunk right there for running the court. So when we get stops and we get turnovers, Ray, we can get up and down the court.
Rule of thumb on a fast break, if you got to say a 3-on-1, 3-on-2, ball stays in the middle.
Ball stays in the middle, and I always talk about when you break the free throw line as a guard with that basketball, that's the moment of truth. You have to make the right play. It's just called the moment of truth.
Did you come up with that saying, or did you steal that from somebody?
I got that from Larry Brown.
I thought you got it from someplace.
I got that from Coach Larry Brown, and it's a true statement. It's a true statement because you watch young guards. A beautiful pass right there by Marquise right there to Horace White. Freshman to freshman.
That's what you're looking for out of Marquise.
That's what I'm looking for. Another beautiful pass by Marquise to Chris Bankston. He's one of those guards that can get in the lane anytime he wants, but he has to learn when you get in the lane, what are you looking for? And that's a beautiful pass again to Chris Bankston.
So Marquise is not in your doghouse, is he?
No, he's not in my doghouse. But it's like myself and Coach Sutton when I was throwing the ball all over the place, and Coach Sutton would sit me down and say, "Make the right play, make the right play." Now I know what Coach Sutton was going through. So Marquise is going to be fine.
In the South Alabama game, you guys were 30 of 49 from the field, 61%, 7 of 15 on threes, and hey, I love this right here. 24 of 33 at the free throw line, but 72%. Where'd that come from?
You haven't said 70 in a long time.
No, I have not.
In a long time. And Ray, you've been to our practice. You know we shoot a lot of free throws. And it was just against the South Alabama, we shot the free throws well.
You know, I told my broadcast partner, Patrick Newton, I said, when Dre Burns comes off the bench, if he starts knocking down shots, look out. This team's very dangerous.
Yeah, it becomes contagious. It becomes contagious. And it's funny because all his teammates are just screaming, "Go, Dre, go. Go, Dre, go." And I've pretty much given him the green light. Loans. He takes good shots to shoot the basketball.
Well, he's got a really pretty shot, and he's very effective, and he is very important to this basketball team. We'll take a pause here on the Darrell Walker Show. When we come back, you'll meet a special Trojan by the name of Rayshon Tucker.
When you choose Westrock Coffee, you realize that it's much more than coffee. This coffee is changing lives from crop to cup. Join us by making a difference, one sip at a time. Find WestRock Coffee at your neighborhood grocery store or on Amazon Prime.
Little Rock Trojan fans, you don't want to miss the 2019 Sun Belt Conference slate. Get to the Jack Stevens Center with your own conference flex plan, or by getting your group to the Jack with some of the top experiences in Little Rock. With 18 home games between our men's and women's programs, you don't want to miss out on the action. Be sure to call the Trojan Ticket Office today at 565-8257 or visit lrtrojans.com for more information. This is our city and our team, so make sure to come out and support your Trojans.
This year, make your outdoor living area more enjoyable. Get yourself an Exmark mower from Cleve Addy Outdoor Equipment on Dyer Springs. Use what the pros trust and come demo the Exmark Radius Zero Turn Rider or the Quest for commercial-grade residential landscaping needs. Purchasing Exmark products is easy and affordable with their special finance offers. Craig and the staff at Cleve Addy can get you what you need and repair what you already have. Are you summer ready? Get to Cleve Addy Outdoor Equipment on Dyer Springs today.
It's not just a coaster, you know. It's an invitation.
Jim Beam on the rocks.
The bourbon that's been making history since 1795 invites you to make some of your own.
Looked at highlights of a couple of games, and 2-2 is much better than 0-2. And so, nice to be back in Little Rock and playing here. Going to head out on the road. You inherited a basketball team. You had a number of guys that you said, "Hey, we're not a good fit here," and so they left. You did have a guy you inherited who was a transfer out of Florida Gulf Coast by the name of Rajon Tucker. Now, I've been doing games for a long time. I don't think I've ever done a game with a guy by the last name Tucker. Particularly a guy who's the first three letters of his first name are Ray Tucker. Very, very talented young man. So I'll tell you what, we sat down with him and one of your assistant coaches and did a little feature piece on him. So let's take a look at that.
The Adventures of Superman. Faster than a speeding bullet. More powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound. Look, up in the sky, it's a bird.
It's a plane.
It's Superman.
We all know there's only one Superman, but our Little Rock Trojans have a player who knows the sky's the limit. While he may not be able to fly, nor is he made of steel, Rajon Tucker is the Iron Man of the Sun Belt Conference. Through 16 games, he's averaging 36 minutes a contest. Plus, he ranks third in the league in scoring, 20-plus a game, and fifth in field goal percentage, better than 50%.
Rajon is a super athlete, and you know, he does a very good job of playing above the rim, but this year what surprised a lot of us is the way he's shooting a three ball.
This guy is as explosive as anybody in college basketball, I think.
Yes, and you know, if you look at any of the high majors and the athletes that they have, I would say Rajon is right up there with him. He has NBA athleticism.
Describe Rajon Tucker's game in 15 or 20 words.
He's a nonstop competitor, and he pushes his teammates. He also is always in constant attack mode. And to me, he's a college basketball version of Russell Westbrook on a fast break.
A 6'5 swingman who transferred in from Florida Gulf Coast, he has a 41-inch vertical. And yes, at times, it appears he can fly.
Probably been able to jump like this since about 10, 11. I took dance classes with my mom, so I did ballet, jazz, tap, so it kind of got my footwork. And, you know, most kids aren't as, you know, balanced as I am, so it helped out a lot.
Do you ever look at the replays of some of the shots you make, how acrobatic you are?
Sometimes I look at it and I'm like, I don't know how I made that, but, you know, hey, everything happens out. I say the basketball gods.
You transferred in here from Florida Gulf Coast. Have you settled in or are you happy?
Oh, I'm definitely happy. I love the environment, love the fans, love my teammates, coaches. I definitely love being here in Little Rock.
Right now, it seems like a good love affair. Rajon's happy to be here, and the fans are thrilled to death that he's in Little Rock. At times, he seems to defy the law of gravity, just like Superman. Can he fly? You be the judge. Darrell Walker, did you ever play with in college, not in the NBA, ever play with somebody with a 41-inch vertical?
No, but I think U.S. Reed was pretty close. U.S. Reed was a heck of an athlete, but Ray John, U.S. was 6 feet doing it, and Ray John 6'5 doing it, so that's a big difference.
So you're giving U.S. Reed credit. I can't believe that.
U.S. was a very good athlete, very good.
And he's working on TV broadcasts.
Yeah, he's doing a good job from what I've been told, doing a very good job. But Ray John is a special player, has a chance to really be a better player, and I'm working with him on his game to get his overall game intact. I think he can become a better defender and a better ball handler.
As a head coach, you have to deal with all these different personalities. It seems to be Rajon Tucker's got a really outstanding personality.
No, he has a bubbly personality. All his teammates love him. He's outgoing. And the good thing about him, even though he's a leading scorer, he's a coachable player. He's a coachable player, and I love coming to the gym and working with Rajon.
Now, he won't like me for saying this, but he had 6 points in the last game. His average was leading the league with 21. But he fit in the games and totally understood him and was much more of a team player.
What I told him during the season when he started getting all these points, I said, now, you understand, these coaches on the other end, they get paid to watch film and try to stop other players, too. And teams are really locking in on him. But overall, defensively, I thought he was great. He rebounded the basketball, and he shared the ball with his teammates.
All right, the week ahead, we're going to make the swing into Texas. We'll take a look at Texas State and Texas Arlington when we come back.
When did Too Big to Fail replace Too Smart to Fail? When did trend overtake truth? When did putting clients first stop being second nature? For us, never.
You can't take a risk in any investment that if it goes wrong and you lose it all, that you endanger the ability of the firm to survive. And that's really what Wall Street forgot.
So when do you want to learn more about Stevens, one of the country's most successful investment banking firms?
It's not just a coaster, you know. It's an invitation.
Jim Beam on the rocks.
The bourbon that's been making history since 1795 invites you to make some of your own.
Duck hunting with Evans is one of my favorite things to do. It's a tradition in our family, and we've been hunting for generations in Arkansas. I grew up hunting with my dad, and now I do it with Evan. And it allows us to spend time together. It allows us to be outside and enjoy Arkansas, teaching them about nature, teaching them about the life lessons that come with it. It's one of my favorite things to do.
Shop Vail Chevy and VailChevy.com today.
Independence, the ability to think freely. It allows you to tell truth from trend, to put clients first, to take the long view.
We're privately owned. We don't have public shareholders, and that's the very significant difference between ourselves and other firms.
Since 1933, Independence has made Stevens one of the country's most successful investment banking firms. Feel free then to learn more about us.
The friendly confines of the Jack Stevens Center, and our Trojans go 2-0 for the week. Didn't last long, Darrell. We're on the road again. Next up is tomorrow night. We play Texas State in San Marcos, Texas, which is a really, really neat little town and a very good basketball team. They're off to a really good start. They're in second place in the league.
Yeah, well, defensively, they're solid. I think they're giving up, 60, 61 points a game. So we're going to have to go down there and take care of the basketball, rebound the basketball, and play defense the way we played defense the last two games at home at the Jack Stevens Center.
Danny Casper's a longtime coach mm-hmm. there. He's been in Texas at another school. Like your mentor, Eddie Sutton, defense is the name of the game for him.
No, you go back to when he was in the Southland Conference with Stephen F. Austin. They defended and is doing the same thing at Texas State. So, once again, it's going to be a tough matchup for us, but I'm looking forward to it because we've been playing pretty good ourselves.
They are a guard-oriented team. Person and Nottingham are very good players.
Yeah, I mean, Pearson, those guys can flat-out shoot the basketball. They're deliberate in their offense, so they cut down the possessions. So, we're going to have to take care of the basketball and make sure we're taking good shots on the offensive end to maximize what we're doing.
They are 7-1 at home, so they love playing at home.
Well, you know, when you can win at home, that's the key. If you can win at home, you're going to have a winning record.
What's the strength of this Texas State team?
Well, I think it's the guards. I think we have to control the guards. I think Lottie and Marquise and Dre, when he's in the game, we're going to have to do a good job of keeping them under control. We're going to have to contest their shots and keep them out of the lane.
Your message to your team as you get ready to go on the road again?
Hey, man, it's simple. I don't want to sound redundant. We must take care of the basketball. We must take this defense from the last two games that we just played defensively, 62 and 59 points, and then we just gotta play. Just gotta play.
You have preached defense to this team, defense, defense. All of a sudden, the light came on.
And the light finally came on. I hope the light stays on because we're a dangerous team, and I keep telling to my guys is when you get stops, we're able to really get out and push the ball at a fast pace and get some easy baskets. So I think the guys are really buying in. Hey, let's get stops, and now we can go on the other end and get an easy shot.
You know, basketball fans get a real treat now. You've got this thing, ESPN Plus, which I'm not real familiar with because I'm always...
I'm still trying to figure it out too, Ray.
Always tied in with you guys, but fans get to watch our games when we're on the road.
Yeah, well, we did the radio show last night. I told the fans that ESPN Plus, these new Samsung TVs, they got all this stuff you can download. So you can download ESPN Plus, $4.99 a month, and you can watch ULR basketball every time we're on TV.
All right, Texas State on Thursday and Texas Arlington on Saturday.
Don't know much about Arlington, but I'll get to that film down the line. But right now I'm just locked in on Texas State. It's going to be a tough trip. We're going to take one game at a time. I'm one of these coaches, Ray, that I take one game at a time. My whole focus is on Texas State right now.
All right, I think we're about out of time here with the second edition of the Darrell Walker Show. Appreciate you folks joining us. Stay warm, and we'll catch you again next week.
The Darrell Walker Coaches Show with host Ray Tucker has been brought to you by Stevens Incorporated, Cleve Addy Incorporated, Zips Car Wash, Glazers Distributing, and these fine brands. We urge you to drink responsibly. And Dillard's Department Stores. Go Trojans!